Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how you can mirror and control any Android device on your computer. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. But to get started with the guide, to mirror and control your Android device from your computer, firstly you're going to need either an Android smartphone or tablet. You're going to need a computer. Then you'll also need a USB cable so you can connect your Android device to your computer. And the USB connection is just for the initial setup. If your computer and Android device is on the same network, I'm going to show you how you can mirror and control your Android device wirelessly as well. And then lastly, you'll need a free software called scrcpy, which stands for screen copy. So firstly, take your Android device and then you want to go and find settings. I'm just going to scroll down on the notification bar and then tap on the settings icon here at the top. Then you want to scroll down all the way to About Phone and select that. If you can't find About Phone, then just use the search function and search for the About section of your phone. But once you get to About Phone, you want to find Software Information and then tap on that, because what you're looking for is the build number. I'm going to tap on the build number 7 times. And then you'll see that developer mode has been enabled. That has to be enabled for this to work. So then you can just go back and then you can do a search inside of settings for the developer options. So once you find this developer options setting, just tap on it. And then inside of the developer options, you need to scroll down until you find the USB debugging option. Then you need to turn that on. You'll get this prompt. Just click on OK and then you can exit out of this. Now you can go ahead and connect your Android device to your computer with the USB cable. So once that's done, open up your browser of choice and then do a Google search for scrcpy. You should get these two results, and I usually download it from the GitHub page. So you can just click on this GitHub link here to open that page. And if you have trouble finding the correct site, you can just click on my written guide that's linked in the description of this video, and I'll have all of the links included in there as well. But once you're on this GitHub page, you can just scroll down until you get the releases here on the right, then click on the latest screen copy release, and then you can just scroll down until you find the assets, and then you can download the screen copy zip file. I'm going to choose Windows 64 because I have the 64-bit version of Windows installed. So I'll click on that to download the zip file. Once it's finished, just click on this folder so you can show it in your downloads folder. The file was downloaded to my desktop, but you can save it wherever you want. So because this is a zip file, you just need to extract it. And I'm just going to right click on it, hold down right click, then drag it to an empty space and then click on extract, then click on extract again. And then with these extracted files, what I recommend you do is just select this folder, right click on it, click on copy. Then navigate to local disk C so you can save it on your C drive. Then just right click and paste it on the C drive and then open this screen copy folder. Now inside of this folder, you're going to find a bunch of files, and the one that you're looking for is this screen copy no console.vbs file. So with your Android device connected to your computer with the USB cable, you can just double click on this file. And you might get a prompt on your phone asking to allow the connection. Now I have full control over my Android phone from my computer. And everything I do on the computer here is mirrored on the Android phone and vice versa. So if you don't mind having your Android device connected to the computer with the USB cable at all times, then you can just go ahead and mirror your Android phone like this. But if you want to use it wirelessly, the thing you'll need to do is connect your computer and your Android device to the same network. So if we have a look at the Wi-Fi settings on my phone here, and we go to the Wi-Fi networks, you'll see that I'm connected to this Wi-Fi network here. And if we go to my computer and hover over the network icon, you can see that I'm connected to the same network. So what I can do in that case, I'm just going to go back on the phone. And just to prove that I'm currently connected to USB, you can see that I'm connected to the Galaxy A20 here on the USB cable. But to connect wirelessly, you can come back to the screen copy folder, then you can click on this open a terminal here.bat file, double click on that, and it's going to open this command prompt window. Then you can type scrcpy space dash dash tcpip, then press enter. It's going to detect your phone on the network and automatically assign the IP to it. And then it's going to close the screen copy window and reopen it on your computer. So once you've done that, you can go ahead and disconnect the USB cable. So you'll see when I disconnect my phone from the computer, the Galaxy A20 is going to disappear from the list of devices on my computer, but I still have the phone connected to screen copy wirelessly. And you can see it is quite responsive and works really well, but that is going to depend on how fast your network speed is of your local area network. Then for those of you with some more computer knowledge, if you come back to this command prompt window, we can just close it and then we can open another terminal. If we go ahead and type scrcpy --help, you'll also find a list of whole bunch of other commands that you can use to tweak this screen copy app even further. But I'm not going to be going through that in this video, but for those of you that are interested in that, you can have a look at that. And the last important thing to note is once you've connected your Android device to your computer wirelessly, you can just go ahead and click on this VBS file again to get access to the Android device. As you can see, I'm not connected to it by USB here on the left, but once you restart the phone or restart your computer, you'll have to connect it via the USB cable first, then run the same screen copy TCP/IP command before you can use it wirelessly. But I hope this guide's been useful to you. Please like the video, and I'll talk to you guys soon.